Everyone wants to get the best education they can get for their kids or grandkids, but choosing the right way for them to learn can be the hardest task of all. One option getting results is education by academic ability and not age-focused classes. Principal Bill Conway and Mum Kathryn Wyer join us on the panel to tell us more. Welcome, guys. Bill, we'll start with you. How does this actually work?
Well, first you have to look at the mainstream classes. And in the traditional system, that whole education system was set up. It's an industrial model in the Industrial Revolution. Educating the masses really needed a system that could be efficient in educating masses of children. So the curriculum was there, designed to be delivered to children in different age groups. And then the children had to basically meet that curriculum in some way. So the way Montessori is different is that what it does is it actually focuses on the child and the needs of the child, and the child is then progresses along and the curriculum follows the child. So the child, as the child gets to a certain ability level interest, then the academics is following them.
So is it more one-on-one learning as opposed to all the kids in a class?
It's still in a group. But the child, let me explain how the child comes to school. And this kind of explains a little bit how it works. So usually you'd come to school, you'd have assignments, the teacher would be there and say, this is what we're going to do today. But in a Montessori class, the child would come, they would come into a classroom that has many ages in the class. There'll be three age groups in the class. But rather than waiting for the teacher to tell them what to do, the child will choose work. So there'll be either things on the shelves that they could choose, there would be material that they were working on the day before that they'd go ahead and choose. They have a certain amount of time also. They don't have to finish it after 45 minutes of reading and then get on to the next subject. They can spend a lot of time with it.
It's listening to this. It sounds fascinating. It sounds terrific. But I think, say, about my eldest daughter, and she wouldn't choose. She'd just go, well, I'm not going to do anything. How do you deal with that? You know, some people will say that Montessori means that kids can sort of slip through the system and not really learn.
No, far from that,
actually. Because they'll cop out. Okay.
No, there's a lot of structure. The curriculum is incredibly comprehensive. So the child who perhaps meanders a little bit, sometimes they need a little bit of that time to choose, because actually choosing is a skill. Mm-hmm. And that's something that we really all need to have, that skill. This is one of those life skills that we should have. Mm. But the one who doesn't choose straight away, the teacher is there as a guide.
Okay.
And so it's not so much that the child just is left there to just wander about. The teacher will go and invite them to a lesson, you know, rather than say, you have to do this, and say, I have this fantastic thing I would like to share with you today. Come with me. And then the lesson happens.
Mm. Now, Kathryn, your daughter started in this system when she was three. How have you found the system and how is she managing through it?
Well, she started when she was three, as you say, and now she's nine and halfway through the primary school program, and it's been an incredible journey for her and us as a family. I've seen a child who's receiving a very good academic education, but she's also an extremely well-rounded child. She's got great sense of who she is and her place within the world, and she's got great self-confidence. And as Bill and Jessica were saying, this ability to choose, I can see very clearly, and being able to make a choice and understand that she has some responsibility for her learning and what she's doing in her life, in her school life at this stage, I think is a fantastic platform for going into adolescence and high school.
And does she learn English and mathematics?
Of course, yeah. The school delivers the New South Wales Board of Studies curriculum just like any other school. Mm. So we have to, well, the school has to be sure that the academic program is there. So that is taken care of, and certainly for our family, having a good academic education is very important. But we also felt that the values around that education were extremely important, and the experience that she had at school. And I see this child who's incredibly curious. She loves learning for the sake of learning, and she feels very empowered in the way she approaches her learning.
I mean, it sounds wonderful and ideal, but is it not true that in the real world, when kids do graduate from school, there are time frames, there are deadlines, there isn't a choice. You do have to do tasks because you're told to do them, or you won't get any money to raise your family.
Yeah, so there's definitely, you can't just do what you want all day. There's choice with limits, and you can't give children unlimited choice. So she definitely has to, she can't just do art all day. I mean, she has to, she'll say, no, well, I have to finish my project or I have to finish my maths work in order to go to the next thing. And certainly, she is 9 going on 10, so high school's in her sight now, so she's getting prepared for high school.
Does Montessori
as well.
Believe in homework?
We believe that a child learns all the time. Mm. So obviously, when you finish school, and if you love learning and you're really an engaged learner, that you'll go home and you'll continue to learn. And so we don't assign homework, but we do encourage children to continue their learning at home. And when they're excited, they've studied something at school, and they want to continue that. And our children do, as Kathryn was saying, that love of school, the love of learning, stays all the way through, and they finish, they're still loving being there. And they love to go home and learn more.
Yeah, it's certainly an interesting approach to education, isn't it? Bill Conway and Kathryn Wyer, thank you very much for coming in. Thank you.